Hi everyone, welcome back to WesKnows Tech News and Reviews. Today we'll be talking about the Huawei Watch Fit. So this is the smartwatch that I've got right here. So it does look like the Honor Watch ES, but no, it's the Fit. So the biggest differences are the fact that it's got continuous SpO2 monitoring. So this is already a very premium feature. Another awesome feature is that it's got dual inbuilt GPS. And today we'll be checking how accurate the heart rate sensor on the back of this watch is, as well as the GPS accuracy. Let's get into it.
If you are new to WesKnows Tech News and Reviews, we talk about the latest tech news. We do brutally honest reviews and share hacks and tricks along the way.
So how did I actually do the test? So I went to the park and, well, this is the park. It's more like a forest. It's not really a park. It's quite dirty and rugged. So I went out for about 45 minutes. I was going uphill, downhill, all over the show. Sometimes in the middle, as soon as I saw a bench, I would get down on it. I would do some push-ups, some press-ups. Then I would be doing some lunges as well as squats. Then without a break, I would continue walking. Sometimes it would be downhill, sometimes uphill. So in some cases, it was quite intense. In some cases, it was a bit more relaxed. But overall, there's 45 minutes of activity, which I was measuring. Now the benchmark for this particular exercise, these 45 minutes, was the Polar H10 ECG chest strap. So that provided the heart rate benchmark. So we'll be comparing the heart rate accuracy of the Huawei Watch Fit optical heart rate sensor versus the Polar H10. Now, in regards to the GPS, I was using two apps, so the Polar Beat as well as the GPX app on my iPhone 12. And of course, we're going to be using that as the benchmark and the GPS, the inbuilt GPS on the Huawei Watch Fit. So the Polar H10 as well as the iPhone 12 with a number of apps are the benchmarks. And of course, this is the tested device. So now let me tell you some key facts about the Huawei Watch, and then we can get into the numbers, into the details. Right, so let's quickly have a chat about the Huawei Watch Fit. If we talk about the display, this smartwatch is also quite premium. The screen size is 1.64 inches, and the fact is it's an AMOLED display. Bright, it's crisp, the contrast is very high, and you can see any of the notifications, any of the metrics and stats in any light conditions. Another important factor, even though it's a budget smartwatch, you don't only have the brightness levels, you also have an ambient light sensor here. That means that it does have auto brightness available. Obviously, you will need to use the Huawei Health app with this smartwatch, and that will give you an absolutely huge amount of downloadable faces. There's been a couple of updates to the smartwatch, and now you can upload, doesn't matter if you're using an Android or an iOS device, you can upload your photos from your camera, from your phone, onto the watch face as custom faces. And that is very handy and quite cool. Now let's talk about the features and functions. If we talk about the features though, let me say, we're not going to be covering off things like your timer, your stopwatch, your weather widgets. No, that's basic. I want to talk about those things that make this budget smartwatch so absolutely cool and quite premium. So what's really cool about the Huawei Watch? Well, the fact is, it's got 95 sport modes. That's plenty. That's more than any of us or most of us will ever use. On top of that, there is a dedicated running app, which will guide you through 13 running courses and can get you running from whether you're a newbie to an expert runner. On top of that, there's a workout course, and in it there are 44 animated gestures, and these animated gestures do look great. They will actually show you how to perform a particular exercise, they will time you, they will guide you through those exercises. That's handy, that's useful, and it will save you from any injuries really, because you can actually see how you should perform those particular exercises. On top of that, there is dual inbuilt GPS. This smartwatch is waterproof up to 50 meters. So you've got no issues with taking it to the shower, to the pool. In fact, because it does have the inbuilt GPS, you can take it to open water swimming. So go to a lake, go to the sea, well, do whatever you need. This thing can take it. If we talk generally about the sensors on this, so you've got continuous heart rate monitoring, then you've got continuous stress monitoring, you've also got sleep monitoring, and it does measure your light sleep, your deep sleep, and REM sleep. So the full three stages. And considering it does use the Huawei TrueSleep technology, which was developed with the Harvard Medical School, so there is a claim to fame. Another really awesome thing about this particular smartwatch is that it can track your SpO2, but not just the on-demand and the spot SpO2 readings. It can actually monitor and track your SpO2 or your blood oxygen saturation over a period of time. It can track it continuously, and that is very useful and quite premium. I don't know of any other smartwatch under 150 or 200 bucks that can do it today. And we've actually done a previous test on that, and you will see that the accuracy is spot on and is just as good as the Garmin Venu. I will put a link to that particular video just above me right now. Anyway, now that we've discussed all the positives about this particular smartwatch, let's talk about the actual test. Let's get into the numbers. Let's check how accurate the heart rate sensor is, as well as the GPS sensor. First of all, let's touch upon the heart rate accuracy. So we know that the benchmark was the Polar H10 ECG chest strap. Now the Polar H10 is supposedly one of the best, or one of the most accurate heart rate trackers, ECG heart rate trackers in the world. It's actually being used for scientific studies, for medical studies, as well as by professional athletes. So it does have claim to fame, and it is quite a trusted device. So let's have a look at the plot. So we can see that the Polar H10 has actually measured the average heart rate at 128 beats per minute, while the max was 160 beats per minute. So we can see that this smartwatch has actually measured the average heart rate of 124 beats per minute, while the max was 153 beats per minute. So that is 4 beats per minute underestimated for the average and 7 underestimated for the max. When we look at the plot, we can see that in general, the tracing is quite good. There were only a number of points where a peak was overestimated by the smartwatch over what was recorded by the Polar H10, but that's at the start of the actual walk. So in the first half, in the first 20 minutes or so, as we get into the second half of the activity, we can see that there was a max being hit, and that's the 160 beats per minute as registered by the Polar H10. And the smartwatch actually underestimated that peak. So overall, we can see that in some of the cases, the smartwatch did underestimate the heart rate as opposed to the Polar H10 ECG chest strap. And that does give us this lower average and the lower peak. Now, is the difference that major? Well, I don't think so. It's all generally under 5%. So over 45 minutes, that's quite a lot of data there. Now, let's take a look at the GPS accuracy, because there were a couple of issues here. We can see that the GPS, as calculated by iPhone 12 using Polar Beat, gave us 3.5 kilometers, while the watch actually gives us 2.81 kilometers. That is quite a massive difference. That's a difference of about 20%. And the previous tests we've done, the GPS tests with the Huawei watch, it has shown approximately the same differences. But anyway, these are the results. Let's sum it up. If you want a smartwatch which is very sporty, which has got a lovely design, a huge 1.64 inch AMOLED display, then the Huawei Watch Fit is amazing. It's a great fit. The price is budget. It offers 95 sport modes. There's a workout course. There's a running app. There's just so much. Well, I can just say that with some of the features offered by this smartwatch, I don't think you can get a better deal on the market today. And that's particularly if you're after the sports, if you're after swimming and you do want to do some open water swimming. Thank you for watching this review and test. If you did find it useful, then please drop us a like. And if you want to see more of the same, you want to see more accuracy tests, then you know what to do. Please click on the red subscribe button below the video, and I'll see you in the next one.